The U.S. military is facing a crisis in the ranks. More soldiers than ever are taking their own lives. The Army is investigating 13 suspected suicides this month alone. That's 54 so far this year. If that pace keeps up, the number for all of 2009 will dwarf the record 143 last year. Today, President Obama addressed the suicide epidemic as he announced changes in the VA medical system.
Sometimes the deadliest wounds are the ones you cannot see, and we cannot afford to let the unseen wounds go untreated. And that's why this budget dramatically increases funding for mental health screening and treatment at all levels.
That increase, of course, comes too late for soldiers who didn't get help, even when they were brave enough to ask for it. Here again is David Martin.
Specialist Carl McCoy survived two tours in Iraq, only to take his own life and shatter the life of his wife, Maggie.
He shot himself. In the bathroom.
Here in this house?
Yes.
According to Maggie, Carl was drinking and their marriage was in trouble. He knew he needed help and scheduled an appointment with a mental health counselor at Fort Campbell, Kentucky. But that morning,
they called and canceled.
And they canceled because?
They didn't have anybody to see him. That was the day before he killed himself.
Maggie was also a soldier, a sergeant with two tours in Iraq. She planned to stay in the Army until she saw this email written by her commander after Carl's suicide.
I know Sergeant McCoy has a lot of problems, but we need people who can deploy. So get her out of the Army or get her out of my unit.
That may sound callous, but it's the reality of life in an Army faced with the unrelenting pace of war and only beginning to come to grips with soldiers so stressed they're taking their own lives.
We saw the numbers go up the last 4 years. We should have been more proactive, all of us, including me, in attacking this problem.
General Pete Corelli, the Army's Vice Chief of Staff, has never seen anything like it.
I've been doing this stuff for 36 years, and I have never run into anything as difficult as this.
Really?
Really.
Carl McCoy was one of 140 known or suspected suicides in the Army last year, an all-time high. This year, the numbers are even worse. 54 in the first 3 months. Here's another alarming statistic. Each day, on average, three soldiers call a national suicide hotline run by the Department of Health and Human Services.
That means each day there are three soldiers out there thinking of killing themselves who are afraid to ask for help from within the Army.
It's the stigma. It's the soldier who wants to reach out to someone who's not in his chain of command because he feels that somehow, if he does do that, he's going to be thought of as a lesser soldier.
Corelli says Fort Campbell has the most aggressive suicide prevention program in the Army. But that has not stopped what he calls a horrible spike. 11 suicides at this one base since the first of the year. One of them during his visit. The fact that these are some of the Army's toughest soldiers, members of the 101st Airborne Division, doesn't protect them from inner demons. Lieutenant Colonel Tom Kunk is the first to be notified whenever a suicide occurs.
And the one common thread is relationship problems.
Problems which set in after the honeymoon of the homecoming is over. Kunk is nearly at wit's end trying to prevent the suicides.
We gotta figure out, okay? It's gotta stop.
But it hasn't. Last month, every soldier was required to watch this interactive video on suicide prevention. Specialist Ken Atkinson watched it, and the next day, in the middle of an argument with his wife, killed himself. David Martin, CBS News, Fort Campbell, Kentucky.